So iOS 11 has a few new keyboard tricks you should know about. First one I want to show you is on the iPhone. So here you see the standard keyboard at the bottom of the Notes app, and you see the keyboard button at the bottom left. It's a globe here on this keyboard. It changes on different keyboards. If I tap it, it will switch between keyboards, and then I could, you know, hit the ABC button there to switch back. So I can go and tap and hold, and I get a list of keyboards I have installed. This is nothing new, but what's new is at the bottom you see there's three representations of the keyboard. The middle one's the normal one, and then I could do the left or the right. So like I'll tap the right one, and now I can see I get a keyboard that's compressed towards the right. This is for single hand typing. So the idea is move the keyboard more to the right. This is very useful, especially if you have the plus models of iPhone with a larger screen. And now you can use your thumb as you hold the phone and reach those keys. Otherwise, reaching the keys all the way on the left was really difficult. Now I can use that arrow there on the left to expand back to full size. I can go again and go to the other side as well. So that's kind of a neat new trick you can do in iOS 11 on the iPhone. Now on the iPad, you've got an even better trick. Notice right here the keyboard has these little gray characters above the main ones. So for instance, above the Q there's a 1, above the G there's an asterisk, H and J have parentheses, things like that. Now you could type on this keyboard just as you could before. So I could just type normal. But if I were to tap a key and swipe down just slightly, I get the special character. So you can see I could easily type these extra characters and even numbers with this gesture. It takes some getting used to. First few times you do it, you don't quite get the characters right. But after you get used to it, you can do it pretty easily. And this works even on the alternate versions of the keyboard. So in other words, I hit the 1, 2, 3 there at the bottom left, and now you can see I basically have, you know, there's three keyboards. There's the letters, there's the ones with the numbers at the top and the main symbols, and then you could press for the special symbols as well. So you can basically access one keyboard deeper using this. So I can, you know, have the numbers here at the top, and now I can access the brackets and other things like that very easily. And there are some special keys that actually work if you swipe up as well, and they are, as far as I can tell so far, the comma and the period key. You see it's got the exclamation point and the question mark, and they're not gray, but I could still do the same thing with those. However, if I go up, I get alternates there. Now there are other keys where this kind of works as well, but instead of just tap and swipe up, you have to tap and hold. So for instance, if you go down to this level and you tap and hold the dollar sign, you see you get other currency symbols above it as well, which makes sense. The dash gives you other types of dashes. So there's some keys that work and some keys that don't. You kind of have to experiment. So the slash gives you backslash. You also get a backslash if you swipe down. So sometimes it doesn't quite make sense as to what keys give you alternates going up as well as alternates when you swipe down. You have to play around and get used to these extra functions.